This one. Nope. This one. Nope. How about this one? Yeah, that's compatible. And that's the case with Somfy Tahoma Apple HomeKit. You need a Tahoma to make Apple HomeKit work. It's the bridge between the Somfy products and Apple HomeKit. But not all products work, not even I/O. So let's have a look at all the different categories and see what works and doesn't work with Apple HomeKit. Hi guys, Otto here, and let's have a look at Apple HomeKit. It's like I said, you need a Tahoma as a bridge, but you also need a motor that's been programmed or a product that's been programmed and paired with a remote control to link it to the Tahoma. So for Apple HomeKit, this is the bridge, but what works? Let's look at roller shutters. Well, first of all, there are I/O motors that are compatible. That's the RS100, which I showed you before, and the Oximo I/O. If you have a different I/O motor, it doesn't work. So the Altus I/O, which is pretty popular with manufacturers because it's a nice low-cost solution, is not compatible. The same goes for the Izimo receiver units. You'd think those be compatible, but they aren't. So they can't be controlled directly from Apple HomeKit. Same goes for everything RTS. So if you have a roller shutter with an RTS motor, no go. So that's it for the roller shutter. So Oximo I/O, RS100, that's a go. All the rest, no, won't work. So let's look at interior decoration. So blinds and roller blinds, Venetian blinds, etc. Same thing there. There is an I/O motor, the Sonessa I/O, the 40 I/O, which is a great product for roller blinds, but is not compatible, unfortunately. The same goes for everything RTS. So if you're looking to control blinds, Venetian blinds, roller blinds, etc., there's unfortunately no solution to connect it directly to Apple HomeKit. You can control it from Tahoma and from your remote control, not from Apple HomeKit. For outdoor window decoration, so for example awnings, there are quite a few solutions. So the Sunilus, the Sunea, and the Maestria I/O are all compatible. So there are a lot of solutions there. However, if you still have an RTS awning, for example, that's not compatible. Now for another group, lighting. And there is unfortunately no good news for lighting at all. The I/O solutions are incompatible, and so are all the RTS solutions. So there's nothing really that allows you to control your lights directly from the Apple HomeKit. If you look at scenarios, that's not a product group, but that's a functionality of the Tahoma. Scenario is basically a sort of program that runs automatically if you press a button, if you use a sensor, or if you set a timer. So for example, you can when you come home, you can automatically open your shutters and turn the lights on, for example. Those are things that you can't control directly from the Apple HomeKit app, nor from voice. So that's something that runs automatically through Tahoma, but you can't start it directly from Apple HomeKit. Of course, these scenarios are usually set on a timer or some kind of input like a sensor, so it can run automatically and you don't always need to address it directly from the app or from the buttons on the Tahoma, but you can. With Apple HomeKit, you can't, however. So scenarios need to be run automatically through the Tahoma. There's no way to start them from the Apple HomeKit. So let's summarize things. There are a few options, a few motors that can be controlled directly from Apple HomeKit, but there's still a relatively low number of products that can be integrated. So that's a shame. I don't think RTS is on the menu or on the program even in the future, so don't expect anything there. So if you have existing products, all you can do is connect them to Tahoma and have scenarios run automatically, but there will be no way to address them directly from Apple HomeKit. There might be some changes in the future for I/O products, but that's a waiting game for the moment because we're not sure of any plans of Somfy at the moment, but there might be changes. I do have some good news because there is a motor that will be available soon that does have an integration with Apple HomeKit for roller blinds, so that's an interesting development. We'll look at it in a future video. But for now, you know what the status is of what you can control through Apple HomeKit and Somfy products. And unfortunately, it's a limited selection at the moment, which hopefully will change soon. If you have any questions about integrations, about the Tahoma Switch or any other product from Somfy, do let me know. The email address is info@tromlo.com. In any case, thanks for watching and see you in the next one.